Alvero Peterson went big for Lancashire, but Middlesex fought back well to leave the game evenly balanced at Lords. Lancashire started the day in a commanding position after closing on day one, 298 for three. Peterson on an unbeaten century alongside his skipper Croft. The pair had moved to their 100 partnership in the final over of day one, and they built upon that stand in the early exchanges on the second morning. Both struck boundaries as the Middlesex attack once again looked toothless. However, the home team finally found some bite through Rayner, the young spinner removing Croft for 46, Simpson with the catch behind the stumps. Brown came together with Peterson, and he took a patient approach to getting his runs, scoring 21 before he fell to Rayner, Fuller this time taking the catch. 368 for five, Peterson was in with new man Livingston, and they took play through until lunch, the South African moving past 150 in the process. After the interval, the pair proceeded to add to their already blossoming partnership, taking it past a century, and Peterson blasted his way ever closer to a double. Livingston, who scored an unbeaten ton against Warwickshire in the previous round, moved past 50 before he fell to Ronan Jones, Fuller taking the catch, 58, the 22-year-old's contribution on this occasion. The partnership was worth 97, and just two overs later, Peterson was out too, Ronan Jones taking the court and bowled, and the South African's innings coming to an end on 191. The next Roland Jones over, Clark was trapped LBW for three, the Middlesex man's fourth of the innings. Rayner emulated the Roland Jones haul with four wickets of his own. Jarvis the last man to go, caught by Robson for 14. Lancashire's total, 513. Middlesex started in good style, as Robson and Gubbins made batting look just as easy as the Lancashire batsmen had done. However, after impressing immensely on debut, it was Matt Parkinson, Lancashire's young spinner, who once again made the breakthrough. Robson caught Livingston for 21 as Middlesex fell to 59 for 1. Gubbins and Eskenazi managed to bat through until the close from that point, though, putting on 87 together, including Gubbins getting to 50. He reached stumps on 71, Eskenazi seven shy of his half-century, as Middlesex closed on 146 for one. The home team still 367 runs behind, with nine wickets still intact.